Hey guys, welcome to Indie Game Hustle. In this UModeler video, we're going to take a look at the push-pull tool. So this should be pretty quick. So the first thing I'll do is go ahead and use the new UModeler tool. And what I want to do is make sure that we're using the box tool, and we're going to go ahead and create a mesh here in our scene. And so the first thing I'll do here also is change this world grid to 0.5, which is fine. And I'll do that. All right, so let's go ahead and create a mesh. Boom, there. So now we have this object here, and I'll just go ahead and flip around to this side. All right, so the push-pull tool is a pretty amazing tool that's gonna be located in the category add. And then to your right, you're gonna see push-pull, and then you'll see multi-push-pull tool. And we'll take a look at both of these. All right, so the first one is the push-pull tool. So what this allows you to do is, well, I'll say this. How I use it is I use it with the align tool or any rectangle tool. So for instance, I'm gonna use this rectangle tool to create this shape here on the mesh, like so, all right? And so now we have this shape. Once you have this here, what you can do is select the push-pull tool, and what we do is hover over a particular shape. What's great about this tool, which is probably my favorite tool, is that it does like an extrusion on the space. But what's even super special about it is that you can push it in just like that. But what's even better is that you can push it all the way through to the other side, creating, I don't know, a window, a hole in the wall, whatever you want to do, right? So for instance, let's use another thing. Let's go ahead and turn snapping off for a minute. And I'm going to grab this circle tool or the disc tool. And I'm going to create a circle here, maybe another circle here, and a slightly bigger circle here. All right, and I'm going to grab that tool, push-pull tool. So all you have to do is select what you want. So you can pop that all the way through, slide that one all the way through, and then slide this all the way through. And it creates a nice, clean extrusion, or almost like a Boolean method, right? It's pretty nice. Now, in terms of the multi push-pull, that one's a little different. So I'm gonna create some more circles. So I'll create a circle here, slightly bigger circle there, and a little circle there. All right, so what I'll do is select the multi push tool. And now what I can do is when I select all of these here, you see this handle, I can move these in and out as needed. So I can do something like that. Now, what it doesn't do is do the same thing that the push-pull tool does for some reason. I'm not exactly sure why that is, but either way, it is super handy nonetheless. So again, all you have to do is create, you can do this with the line tool as well. So for instance, if we have this line tool, and right now I can just kind of create whatever I want. This is pretty sweet. And say I do something, I don't know, seems reasonable, right? All right, so now we have this shape. And so we use the push-pull tool, and we can go ahead and push this puppy in just a little bit if that's what you're looking for, or you can go all the way through just like so. And that's pretty cool. I really like that tool. I hope you can maybe find a lot of use to it. There's a lot of applications you can do, or a lot of things that you can apply this to with modeling, whether it's creating entrances or doors, or kind of blocking out like the shape of like a weapon, that sort of thing. But there's a lot of use cases around that tool. So in the comments, I'd love to see if you guys have anything, any questions about it. But otherwise, that is the push-pull tool. Have fun. See you guys in the next video.